Dick.
Hello.
Hello.
Yes, I'm pulling up about a wee candid camera story regarding the British Rail. You know,
yes,
it's a good thing because I drive my car down to the car park and I take the train into Glasgow Central. And it's quite good, but a funny incident happened in Glasgow Central last Monday when I was there.
How long have I been asleep for? What's the time? It's 23 minutes to 11 o'clock, folks. When did I drop off? Jackal. Jacket?
What? Scotty? Listen, it's about road safety.
Road safety.
Right, I was going into town last night.
You stay in your bed.
I was going into the town last night, and there was a lorry driver in front of me with an indicator on for about 5 miles. And it was a man driver. That's my bird whistling, by the way. A cockatiel.
A cockatoo?
A cockatiel.
Have you had a cockatoo?
No.
Always a cockatiel?
Yes.
Right.
Listen.
You've never had a cockatoo?
Are you listening? We're talking about road safety. Be serious. Can you not be serious? You just make everybody giggle. Right, you listening? On a roundabout. Driver, driving on the left-hand side. Right past me and then overtakes me to go into the right-hand lane. Guess what? Another male driver. So you ones are not all perfect. Right, Scotty?
Are you sure you've not had a cockatoo?
No! I've got a dog and a cat and a bird.
What's the difference between a cockatoo and a cockatoo then?
I don't know. Right.
Is there one? No.
Well, I don't know.
Have you ever had a parrot?
No, I've got one. It's called my husband.
Ah, right.
Right, I better go. I'm going to my work, Scotty. I better go.
You're away.
I'm going to my work.
Well, you're to your work? Well, here, you'd better get away. It's 22 minutes to 11. Right. Are you ready? You start.
I love to get you on a slow boat to China. All by myself, alone. I'd like to get you on a slow boat to China. All by myself, alone.
Very nice, dear. What about that? Dinky do. I think we'll bring out a wee single, eh?
I think you should.
Bring a wee single out in memory of your dad.
Oh, that'd be great.
Hey, how you careful, lady? I'm not a bad singer, actually. No, it wasn't too bad, you know. Now, come on. Jack the grass. In a day like this. Jinty, the queen of the shinty.
Hi.
Hi.
Oh.
How are you?
Fine.
I think you do.
Are you listening to Central FM?
All right.
And I was in my pal's house this morning.
I've never heard of that, dear.
And it was about women drivers?
Yes.
Well, what about the men drivers and their mobile phones?
What about the mobile phones?
I just driving along the road and trying to talk on the mobile phones.
That is terrible.
And then you get the...
I've never seen that.
You've never looked...
What have we got here? Stuart, are you there, Stuart?
I'm here.
Yes.
How you doing, Scotty?
I'm dinky-doo.
Not bad. Listen, it's about women drivers.
Yes?
No, I think we should just... send them in the hospital, and then...
Stuart!
Aye.
Are you needing outside help, son?
Nah.
Well, I'm going to get the studio nurse to you. Nurse, could you attend to this boy here? Just put your head between your knees, Stuart, and just sit down there for a minute, and we'll get somebody to you. Karen!
Hello? Yep, I think the solution is to ban all men drivers.
Why is that, darling?
And give them bikes for a wee bit.
Give them bikes?
And then
or give them bikes, did you say?
I think the solution would come
did
to
Did you say give them bikes?
Sorry?
Did you say give them bikes or bikes?
Bikes as in two wheels.
Bikes as in a wasp's nest.
No.
Like, you know, Tam O'Shanter as bees, bizzoo, an angry bike.
I think if we gave them bikes, let them ride around on bikes, and then we'd see who the problem was.
But that means you've still got the women on the road.
Women are much more careful.
Don't be so stupid.
I'm not a driver myself.
Of course you're not.
I will be getting a car soon.
Of course you're not.
What do you mean?
You've got no brain.
I've not got a brain.
I wouldn't like you out in the road. You're a nightmare.
I'm a nightmare.
An absolute nightmare.
I'm perfectly safe.
We still wouldn't stop the women chatting. We must gag them.
Driver.
Rubbish. I'm going to send my license back to Swansea.
That'd That'll be right. Men have too... Men think about sex too much. Men are far too preoccupied to see good-looking women on the road. They turn to their mobile phones. Are you listening? Hello?
Oh, the fog
winds
up with a love on me. I step away with a sunlight to my lord. Show my tumble and look round out.
Men's minds are far too preoccupied.
As my dad. Here we go, Molly.
Scotty.
In Dublin's first city, where the girls are so pretty.
I phoned in to say hello.
Set my eyes on sweet Molly.
Are you going to listen to me this time?
I'm always listening to you.
I've never
been
horse boat
bubble
with the gallstones.
Yes, your gallstones?
Right, well, this is the first I've heard
to hear. Is gallstone no in Ayrshire?
No, but I'll tell you, mine's are in the drawer.
Yes, have you brought them back with you?
Aye.
I bet they're really big chuckies. They'll be about half an inch broad each. And they're
no,
sort of,
mine's are wee bules, just wee bules.
Just wee ones, and are they sort of grey-green colour?
Brown.
Brown?
Brown.
Whoa.
Scotty, what a time. This
Molly
is the
Brown.
I've got to listen to you, because
your eyes off the road. Now, men drivers tend to look ahead and talk out of the side of their mouth saying, hey, listen, hen,
listen, they only talk out the side of their mouths when they sort of, like, come from Dorset or Somerset.
Here, the Zoyder apples grows down here, you know, you can.
We come up from Somerset, where the Zoyder apples grow.
Here, boy gum.
Hey, boy gum.
But listen, they turn...
I bet you thought you were on the wrong program there.
Here.
I bet you thought you were on the wrong program when you heard me sort of, you know, like do that. You thought I'm on the wrong program, didn't you?
I didn't think I was on the wrong program, but I listen to your program quite often.
Oh, I thought you thought you were perhaps on sort of like an old one that used to have a tune like that.
It was all about
Robin Hood and firing arrows and things. What was it called now?
That's Lincolnshire, you dovey bugger.
Oh, is it? Oh, I doubt. Oh, we come up from Somerset, where the cider apples grow.
Poor bugger, Janner. Anyway,
listen, will you please stop swearing on my program? I cannot understand why mothers will take their children to the supermarket in order that they can misbehave.
Yeah.
You know, that tantrum, this lying on the floor, I don't want No, listen, I mean, oh, they'll not be asked to pay or anything. They've only been asked to go through the checkout in the hand of their mum. But they lie down on the floor, they kick their heels, they say, I don't want to. It was a bit like me when I got taken off the nights. Do you know, it's that sort of thing.
Yeah.
But, I mean, you know, I mean, the top man, wee Bobby, he sorted me out.
Yeah, I mean, it is.
Wee Bobby, the station master.
Oh, yeah. So when he come back on the night?
Well, I don't know. I'll need to speak to wee Bobby because I'm not exactly, you know, on good terms at the moment with him.
What, wee fat Bob?
No, wee Bobby, the station master.
Oh, right.
The manager, aye. You know, I don't know if he's in Tenerife or what at the moment.
Oh, right. Wee fat Bob's quite good as well, but I think we miss you at night.
Yes, I know, and it certainly works offshore sometimes, so.
Oh, yeah, you know? Yeah.
So we'll need to find out what's going on there. Stephen!
Hello, Scotty, it's Stephen for Galston in Ayrshire.
Galstones?
Yes.
I've had them. Galstones?
Yes.
No, it's a wonderful park. Galston's very nice. New Mills, Ken New Mills?
Yes, 2 miles up the road, yeah.
2 miles up the road, very nice. Moscow?
That's 2 miles north.
Sorn?
Yeah, it's 7 miles south.
Aye, I don't know where you are at all.
Tell me, Scotty, I'm...
Darvel?
Oh, 5 miles east.
Oh, very swish. So everyone's actually near you, but no one's actually where you are.
Centre of the universe, Scotty.
Galston. Marvellous, Galston.
Tell me, Scotty. My pal was on last week, Ross to Kilmarnock, and he was telling you about me taping you in video.
Yes, I heard about him, yes.
I just phoned up to say, Scotty, your show's marvellous because I'm on holiday today.
Do you get it in Galston loud and clear?
It's no bad, a wee bit hissy, but no bad.
A wee bit hissy, that's the lovable lassie talking to me, she gets a wee bit hissy.
Alright.
It's like a pantomime, you see, I say, I'm Scotty McClure, and everyone goes, hiss, hiss.
Brilliant, Scotty. You're
That's
so
why
magic.
It's a wee bit hissy, you see. They're all shouting, behind you! Oh, no, you're not!
Scotty, Scotty, I'm going to tape your show every day in video. I get the full 3 hours.
Brilliant.
Because I go in a van every day, and some places I go to, you're just a wee bit in the fringe of your reception.
I'm just a wee bit faint.
Yep.
Sometimes I do that and I stick my head between my legs and I'm fine. People say, Scotty, you're a wee bit faint today. I say, I know, but there's a bit more colour in my cheeks, eh?
You're some man, so you are. But just wondering, Scotty, is there any chance of you coming back on at nights?
Well, it depends. I got thrown off the nights because there was too much carry on.
Oh.
So the boss had said, he said, we've had a lot of complaints about you at night. I says, oh, have you? He said, so we're putting you in the morning, so I'm sort of on probation at the moment.
Oh,
so who knows, if I earn my spurs, I might get back on at night.
Well, here's hope.
You see, the boss can keep an eye on me. Well, he can't at the moment because he's in Tenerife, but he likes to keep an eye on me, you know, all that sort of stuff. He looks on, how's my clue doing today? Not too much carry on, I suppose. I hope nobody's said shecht or pash. It's all that, you see. So there we go.
Yeah.
But there's no problem.
Nice to talk to you anyway, Scotty.
It's lovely to talk to you. And give my love to Galston, because it's a part of the world that I'd like to see populated again.
You're some man.
All the best.
Right. Cheers, Scotty.
Cheers and now. Wonderful part of the world. What a nice chap. Jacket?
Hello, Scotty.
Hello.
What do you do when you see a spaceman?
A given.
Park?
Aye. What do you do when you see a spaceman? You park. Right, man.
All right, Scotty.
Yes, sir.
Remember me from the other day?
Everybody remembers you from the other day.
Yeah. What I want to talk about today, right, is these folk, apparently they're taping your show and sending it abroad, yeah?
Yes.
And I mean, I think that's absolutely frightening. I mean, Scotland's going to become the laughing stock of the world if they keep doing that, you know what I mean?
Now, why is that?
Because they're going to have to listen to you making a berk at yourself every day, you know what I mean?
Making a berk out myself?
Yeah.
I've never made a berk out myself, or a burk. Burk is actually the word.
Well, whatever way you like, you say tomato, I say tomato.
You say tomato, yeah. I say tomato. I mean, now, in what way could I possibly make a berk out of myself?
Mean, it's just the way, like, you know what I mean, like, you know, the law according to Scotty McClure, you know, you're an idiot if you disagree with you, and you're an intelligent person if you agree with you. I mean, that's
nothing
the way you
wrong
do
with
it,
that. That's a very, very, very clear rules and regulations to the programme.
All right, so I mean, that's the way it works then, is it, aye?
Well, I mean, why not? What's do you have a problem with that?
No, and remember we were talking about talent.
No, wait a minute, hang on. Do you have a problem with that, Colin?
Yeah, well, I mean, how's that a phone in then? You know, with folk, you know, like, trying
what
to
do you mean, how is
that
a phone in? We talk to about 200 people every day, so what do you mean, how is it a phone-in?
Well, I mean, like, you know, I mean, where's folk putting across their opinions?
No, you're putting yours across just now.
No, but I mean, like,
you're putting yours across just now, Colin. It's a phone-in programme. If you disagree with me, you phone in.
Yeah,
if
and then
you
get
agree with
an
me.
Idiot for your
no,
trouble.
You don't get called an idiot, right? The only reason you get called an idiot is because you are one.
Now, I'll tell you, see something, by the way. See when Scott FM decided to get you in, I bet you they were sitting up there saying, you know, let's see, a great idea for a show. Let's get a moron to talk to morons. Who do we know? Oh, I know a real
listen,
moron.
Colin, really I really, really thoroughly object to you, right? Calling the people of Scotland morons.
I'm not calling the people of Scotland morons.
On what do you base it?
I'm calling your listeners morons.
Well, I'm sorry, my listeners are the people of Scotland. They are one and the same.
No, I mean,
there's a small percentage in the north and a small percentage in the far south of Scotland perhaps have difficulty in hearing me.
Yeah, I mean,
right? Now, the rest of central Scotland, right, and I really thoroughly, thoroughly object to you calling my listeners morons.
You do it half the time yourself.
I don't.
Yes,
I don't. I only call people like you morons because, as I say, you are one. That's
yeah,
you scored on. That's
you
scored
morons,
on two counts
yeah.
already.
Yeah, you're all women.
Not only are you an idiot, but you're also a moron. Now, I mean, are you just here to explain to us how you're a bad example of a Scotsman?
No, no, I'm trying to stick up for this nation.
You're not sticking up for the nation.
Yeah, I...
Right, the only thing that's stuck up is you.
No, I think you're the one that's stuck
no,
up.
No, I'm not stuck up at all, yeah, Sonny,
sure.
And don't push your luck with me.
I bet you stay in Bear's Den, don't you?
How dare you?
You do.
How dare you?
You've got a Bear's Den accent.
How dare you talk to me like that, matey?
Yeah, you definitely
you really
do.
Want to catch a grip of yourself, Colin, because I'll tell you, you're a very, very bad example to the people of Scotland.
But, I mean, like, you know,
and
we
in fact,
should have a debate.
In
and,
fact,
like, you,
you deserve
to
be.
To
you people
you
like you should be banned from this programme.
rubbish. It's people like me that make this a lively programme with a bit of intelligence.
A lively programme with a bit of intelligence. I think you're pushing your luck now, Sonny.
Hardly. Come on, Scott.
Absolutely. Absolutely. No, the whole thing about this is, Colin, you will have to realise, right, that this is the future for radio in Scotland. This kind of show is what will drag radio and drag the people of Scotland kicking and screaming into the 21st century.
And I mean, when are you actually going to stop talking about women drivers? I mean, it's just tedious.
I haven't mentioned women drivers today, you have.
No,
nobody else has mentioned them, you have. You're the only person who seems to be obsessed with women drivers.
Hey.
Now, will you please stop turning my show into a discussion about women drivers when we've already banned the subject?
And remember, we were talking about talent. Well, I looked
at... Well, listen, you really are pushing your luck now
to actually talk
in the same breath as me about talent, Colin, because that's something you're totally devoid of. Now, I really don't think you're qualified to talk about talent.
I looked it up in the dictionary.
I don't mind you being an idiot. I don't mind you being a moron, right?
We
can tolerate these
people. Your ability is
don't come on here and tell me that you think that you've got talent.
You speak inane drivel.
Colin, will you please stop talking over me when I'm trying to get some sense into your thick head?
Hey, you were talking over me, man. I started my sentence.
You should start your sentence, and the sooner the better. I would send you for 5 years initially, and maybe give you time off for good behaviour, provided you rehabilitated yourself.
Yeah, I don't even think you got an O grade in English, you know that?
How dare you?
You didn't. Yeah.
How dare you?
I think the only O grade you got was home economics. And that was only because they felt sorry for you.
How dare you?
You know, what the rest of the nation does. Yeah?
I'm appalled at you.
How?
I'm appalled at you reducing this programme, the biggest phone-in programme outside London, to that level of debate.
If anything,
it's home economics that you did, matey.
How do you?
Right? Because your knowledge seems to be of pies.
I'll bet you
pies
haven't
only.
Even got five listeners lined up. In fact, I'll donate a fiver to charity if you can cut off five listeners in a row. And that, you know, that's a promise.
All right, one. Right, there you are. A fiver to that. Now, who have we got here? Here, Ross. Are you there, Ross? Hello, Ross.
Hello, Scotty. I am called Ross. I am on a voice machine. I cannot type fast. Please give me time.
All right, Ross.
Stop taking the Mickey out of you.
Yep, you're good.
Scotty, keep me going by Scotty. Nice talking to you. I hope to see you soon.
Thank you very much. Wonderful stuff. There we are. That's Ross. He's typing out on a voice box. That's absolutely marvellous.
Exactly.
Definitely. Right, John.
Hi, Scotty.
Yes, John.
It's one of your old subjects. It's about the old mumbling plants. They had the old granny things last week, you know, the holiday period.
Yes.
And she heard the programme. She said to the wife, what are these mumbling plants? So she shot out the tune on Saturday morning there, Scotty, and the old Jim is determined to get a pair of these mumbling pants. You know, the old granny?
Yeah.
So the wife gets her a pair of the mumbling pants and she comes up the road with them one man and, my God, Scotty, they weren't the mumbling pants, they were dear droopy pants. And Scotty,
it's not mumbling pants, it's mumbling plants, is it not?
Mumbling pants, Scotty. And Scotty, the best bit was still to come. So the other weekend, they're wasting a wee bit of the curate, the tidying up
and
the old...
And they're called mumbling plants because you can see the lips moving but you don't know what they're saying, is that right?
You hit it in the head. Well, actually, I've told everybody that one. I've told everybody that one.
I in the head, I'll tell you that.
Got it. So, the best is still to come. So the old Jean's like, get that ladder. And Sarah's going to get the ladder, Scotty, and she goes up the ladder. She's a wee bit creaky. She says, sit down there, son. And she says, give me a shoe today, because I'm going to go up there and do a bit of high dust and wear mumbling pants.
What was she wanting? Was she wanting a wee punty up?
A punty up to do the high dust and wear mumbling pants. It was a sight and a half to behold, Scotty.
Oh, I'll bet it was. I think I'd rather not behold that if you don't mind.
But just shows you, Scotty. And the audience says, I wish you mumbling pants for a bit when I was a lassie.
Oh, just as well, the one day. There might have been more to you about.
Well, see you later then, Vicky.
Oh, I hope not. Mary.
Hi, Scotty.
Yes, dear. I think we've had enough of him.
Aye.
Now, what can I do for you?
Just to tell you, Scotty. See you last time I phoned you in the morning.
Yes.
Well, hell don't. You know my bloody shirt was £5.
£5? It's a bargain, isn't it? It's an absolute bargain.
Is it?
Colin.
Scotty, how you doing?
I'm fine.
It's about your theme tune in the morning.
Yes.
Yeah, I've got a better suggestion for it.
Yes.
What about the Scarecrow song from The Wizard of Oz?
The Scarecrow song? I'll just make a wee note. Would you like to give us a bit of it?
Well, do you know how it goes?
Well, you tell me, and I'll tell you if I know how it goes.
Oh, well, I'm not singing. I'm a really good singer.
Well, can you take your shoes off and hum?
Hey,
how does it go? How does the Scarecrow song go? Just give me an indication. You don't need to be a good singer.
You know, it's the one you know about, If I Only Had a Brain. But anyway,
If I Only Had a Brain. Is that because it's your theme tune?
No, you want to talk about smelly people, because every time we see you, you get the same clothes on.
You're a dirty midden, you are.
No, you're a dirty midden.
You're a filthy midden.
Anyway, I mean, I see your show's up to its usual dazzling standards.
It's wonderful, isn't it? At least it's dazzling you. David!
Hello?
Can you turn your radio down, David?
Wait a second. Adam, going to turn the radio down?
Come on, Adam, turn that radio down
Adam,
now, Adam.
He's shouting to turn the radio down.
I'll be telling you again, Adam.
Hello?
Hello there.
Hello, Scotty.
Has that Adam been told to turn that radio down?
That's my big brother. He's over for America, staying.
Oh, he's an awful man.
Ah, he is. How you doing, Scotty?
He says he's over from America. He stays out in Easterhouse.
No, he didn't stay in Easterhouse. He's saying he stays in Easterhouse.
Right, come on.
Right, what I was wanting to talk about is, well, everybody phones in and asks you questions, Scotty.
Yes.
Well, I was wondering if you'd like to ask me any.
No. Jill.
Hello, Scotty. Good morning.
Good morning.
I wonder if you'd like, I could talk to you again about the ethics, using artificial insemination.
Now, is ethics near to suffix?
No. Well, you put me off there.
Are you an ethics girl?
Yes, I am.
Right.
Okay, well, it's between, using artificial insemination for homosexual couples, or, you know, or people with medical conditions. This is going back 10 years ago. My friend, she's was born a diabetic, and she married at 22, and they started, you know, to try to have a family straight away. And basically the doctors then said, look, it was impossible, because the complications of a diabetic, and her having, like, blocked fallopian tubes. So they were unable to be... to adopt children, but they were able to foster. Anyway, quite recently they were able to actually afford to go private, and they went down to London, and thankfully they were successful using that artificial insemination, and she was able to go through a normal pregnancy and had a little girl. I know. Anyway, and she's now naturally had been able to have a baby. So I think using...
Oh, help. How long have I been out? How long have I been away? Splash me with some of that water there for a freshen up. I'm sorry, folks. I don't know what's happened here. I don't know how long I've been out, but just forgive me till we press up. Stephen!
Scotty.
Stephen, have you got the time on you, son?
I do.
What is it?
It's 20 to 10.
No, you're two minutes fast.
No, I'm not.
You're 2 minutes fast.
Hello?
Yes, so I wouldn't be lied to, Stephen. Now give us a call, 0990...
Ron! Hello, Scotty!
Yes, Ron!
That was a bit of a nutcase, was he not?
A wee nutcase there!
Do you mind me?
Everybody minds you!
For the night show!
How could you not mind you with a voice like that?
You don't mind me?
Everybody minds you!
Wee Bucket!
Wee Bucket!
From Dalgetty Bay!
With a B, yes!
No, from Dalgetty Bay!
Yes, absolutely, Dalgetty Bay! Yeah. I thought Dalgetty Bay was shut!
What?
I thought Dalgetty Bay was shut!
No, of course it's not! It's building up fast!
Building up fast!
Aye! Well, anyway, I want to talk to you about the subject!
The subject?
Aye!
Aye! Can you keep this up?
Aye.
Aye, right. I might hold you...
I know somebody that's gay.
I might hold you to that.
I know somebody that's gay, you see.
Well, right, in Dalgetty Bay.
Aye.
Gay in Dalgetty Bay.
Aye.
Oh, that's great.
He's a real crackpot.
A crackpot?
Just like that last man that was on.
Yeah.
What are you laughing at, Scotty?
I'm laughing at your Dalgetty Bay accent.
There's nothing wrong with Dalgetty Bay accents.
Is there not?
No. You should come here, Scotty.
You can come here.
Folk love you here, by the way.
No, come here.
No, you come here.
You come here and say
that. Not everybody talks here like this in the bay.
I thought I've heard.
Eh?
I come from the bay myself.
There.
That's where we all talk like this.
Which part of the bay do you come from?
The dog.
The what?
The dog.
Oh, I came that.
It's the first part of Dog Etty.
Aye.
Are you from the Etty?
Aye.
Are you a Yeti from the Etty?
No, just the Etty.
Just the Etty?
Aye. Do you remember me?
No.
Do you know?
I've forgotten you now.
We bucket from Murkeering High School.
Chris. What was that boy like? He's about 14.
That was great, that.
Good that job. Was...
Hey, listen, I'm going to pull you up here.
You better. You better be quick about it and all.
Oh, you going to cut me off?
No. It's just the news is coming up.
Oh, God. No, it's not.
Eh? Well,
no,
what
not.
Was your point?
Well, my point is, I disagree with you.
That is your point. That's your point, that you disagree with me. Is that
hey,
it?
Hey, you're a well man, hey. You're on top form, mate. You're on top form. Your show is going better and better and better.
You're ridiculous here.
You're a dunderhead.
You're a complete and utter dunderhead.
You stop this.
You smell.
Wait,
I can smell you.
Get
away from that wireless.
Ridiculous.
Get away from that wireless. You're stinking the place out.
I smell.
Get away from that wireless. You're stinking the place out.
You dirty person.
You midden.
You're a midden.
You're a midden.
And don't you start laughing now.
Don't you start
laughing. Get me going here.
Don't you, nobody wants to get you going.
Hey.
Do you know the road to Dundee? Well, get on it. Get
one to the sides. And pop. Clap. Come on now, up in the gallery, you all know it. Tra-la-la, la-la-la, la-la, and hop, ball change. Back, together, up to the side and the arms. Dear me. Take your leg round the back of your neck, and back again. Other leg round the back of your neck, and back again. There you go. And your head right round, 360 degrees and back. Then the other way and back. Don't try that at home now. That was for entertainment purposes only. Only joking. This is not the step aerobics class, believe it or not. It's Scotty McClue's phone-in live on Scott FM.